believe that the body of Christ is about to see a manifestation of what Psalm 68 verse 11 declares,
you can
that
go,
the Lord
you
gives
can
the
go
command
on
the woman.
Who can find a virtuous woman?
It says, I'll adjust your crown, reflecting on the life of Queen Esther. And the theme verse, and I apologize, that was not included in the poster as well, but it's the theme is taken from Esther 4, verse 14. Alter your crown. We all know that as children of the Most High, that we are royalty, and as such, is give us the title as queen. But our queenship is different from that of the world. We don't wear a visible crown. We wear an invisible crown, and we are answerable to one that is greater than us. So we do not operate in our own glory, but we operate in his glory. And the crown tonight, or this even that I'm making reference to, is our identity, who we are in Christ. Each of us, when we enter the kingdom, when we become born again, we were given an assignment, and it is meant to show forth God's glory. I don't know if anyone here has found their purpose. If you have, please continue to let your light shine. And if you haven't, this is an encouragement for you to seek your purpose. But in order to find your purpose, you need to know yourself. You need to know who you are in Christ, because that will give you the confidence to carry out the mission that God has given you. And, you know, not knowing who you are is a major barrier in accomplishing your task. We need to know who defines us. We need to know, you know, in its true essence, who do we belong to? The world tends to define us by our accomplishments, our job status, or education, but that's not what God defines us as. Queen Esther was an orphan, and God used her in a mighty way to rescue a generation. Had she not, well, God would have definitely found somebody else if she had refused. But she rescued a generation of people, and we are here. We are learning about her, you know, and her courage and what she did in order to accomplish that which the Lord had for her. So we need to know that we are children of the Most High God, the Supreme Being. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. He said, before I formed you, he knew us. We are his heirs. We are his righteousness. So tonight, remember that. Know who you are and seek your purpose.
Time to keep your head down. There's a time, but it's not now. Sometimes you gotta go. trust you. Made to lay my life before you. So I gotta go. Sometimes you gotta speak when you don't have the blood. Sometimes you gotta move when everybody else says you should stay. No way, no, not today. You gotta ask if you want an answer. Sometimes you gotta stand apart from the crowd. Long before your heart could run the risk. You were born for this. 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 You were born for this.
Particularly like the theme that has been chosen. Adjust their crowd. Yes. Reflections on Queen Esther. And as was aforementioned, that is taken from Esther chapter 4 and the verse 14, which I will read in your hearing. It says, "For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet, who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?" Just bow your hearts with me in prayer. Father, we just honor you this afternoon for being our daddy. We are grateful to you, oh God, that you have called us. You chose us. Your word says that we did not choose you, but you chose us. And you chose us to be impactful, to be intentional, to effect change wherever we are. And so, Father God, as we come this afternoon, we just entrust ourselves into your capable hand. We pray that if there's anything in us that dishonors you, that you will cleanse us, that you will purge us, you purify us, Almighty God, and that you will cause us to reflect you in all that we do and say. Be glorified in our midst this afternoon through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Now, I believe that this is a season where the beauty and power of women will be on display. When I talk about beauty, I am not referring to beauty as is prescribed by the world's standard. You know, the long flowing tresses, the extended eyelashes, the fake, everything. But I'm referring to a beauty that emanates from the grace of God on our lives. Decades of oppression will come to an end. Satan knows that when women discover who they really are in Christ, that his kingdom will be in trouble. I believe that the body of Christ is about to see a manifestation of what Psalm 68 verse 11 declares, that the Lord gives the command. The women who proclaim the good tidings are a great host. A strategic time in human history is coming when God will give a command. And an army of women will proclaim the good news of the Almighty God in the earth. And we will do that with distinction. We will do that with dignity. to advance the kingdom of God. Is there an amen on this platform?
Amen.
Amen.
The devil has blurred the lines and devalued the power of being feminine. We don't have to hide our feminine qualities and compete with men to accomplish our purposes. Let me say that again. We don't have to hide our feminine qualities and compete with men to accomplish our purposes. We must develop a clear understanding of who God created us to be. We must get a clear vision of God's ideal and make his standard the standards by which we live. Women were created to express God's rule and reign in the feminine form. God has mantled women with the gift of leadership to influence and impact the world for good. God created women to be nurturers. We were designed to influence and inspire those in our sphere with godly wisdom and gentle encouragement. We are helpers. We support and champion dreams and visions. God did not make a mistake when he created the woman. Women all over the world are declaring, I was created for more. I was created to be more than a companion, more than just being a mother, more than just being a housewife. God is liberating us to move from a place of inferiority, competition, and fear to a place of power, influence, and courage. No longer are we feeling the pressure to put on a show to impress the masculine, but we are being healed and delivered from tradition and religion that have held us captive for centuries. The Lord is releasing his favor and grace upon us to fulfill his purposes in the earth. The question is, will we submit to the process of being trained and commissioned to fulfill these purposes? We must be willing to adjust our crowns to align with the will and purposes of God. My sisters, it is all about what he desires and requires from us. We are being called to use our gifts and talents to impact our society, to preach, to teach, to pray, to prophesy, and deliver. Gone are the days when women were told to be silent. And even if the denomination that you're a part of stipulates that, God has opened up a browser for your voice to be heard. I will not be silent. I will always worship you. As long as I am breathing, I will always worship you. Somebody help me just exalt the King of Glory.
Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord.
Amen. Let us thank him that he has given us a voice and that we're using that voice for his glory and his honor.
Amen.
Bless the name of the Lord. God is empowering us to follow his ordained directive. We are arising and influencing the world in ways we have never done. Women are rising with a new level of determination, courage, and unwavering faith. With this newfound resolve, we must be prepared and positioned properly. We must examine how God wants to raise us up to influence the kingdom and the world. I believe that the combination of prayer and action will be two major keys to women influencing their fears. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise God. It's not just praying alone. We have to activate the prayer The Bible says faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead. So we might be praying, somebody might be praying for a job, and we have not sent out any applications. Yeah? Somebody else might be praying for a spouse, but you're not putting yourself in that position where you will be noticed. Amen. That is not how it works. We have to act on what we are praying about. Bless the name of the Lord. Women are some of the most valued, untapped resources. We are God's secret weapon. Light is shining, and favor from God is being bestowed on women to be all that they can be. Godly grace-filled women are being positioned to overthrow the plans of the enemy. And can I tell you a secret? You and I are numbered among those women. The story of Esther is one of courage and righteous boldness, exercised with great wisdom to confront injustice and deliver a generation from destruction. We are the modern day Esther. And I want you to place your hand on yourself and say, I am a modern day Esther.
I am a modern day Esther.
Yes, you are. We are living in a world that is filled with injustice. And there is a generation that is waiting on us to arise.
Hallelujah.
There is a generation that is waiting on us to arise so that they can fulfill the purpose for which they were created. Romans 8, verse 19 to 22 states that the creation waits in eager expectation for the children, the queens of God, to be revealed. The whole creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth. Praise the name of the Lord. Children and women who are emotionally, physically, sexually, and all the alleys that are being abused, they are waiting on us, Queen Esther, to arise. Teenagers and adolescents who are confused about their gender, males thinking that they are females, females thinking that they are males. They are waiting for the modern day Esther to arise. The sex trafficking, violence of every sort, the whole creation is groaning, waiting for the modern day Queen Esther to arise. God is waiting on the modern day Esther to rise up and bring an end to these evils. The modern day Esther must have a humble, grace-filled, teachable spirit acquired through submitting to the process of the Lord. There is no place for arrogance. There is no place for pride. There is no place for indifference. There is no place for self-pity. There is no place for bitterness, fault fighting, sabotage, aloofness in the company of the modern day Esthers. These women must be motivated by the love of God, leaning on the strength and abilities of the Most High God. The modern day Esthers will not be intimidated by natural laws or deterred by the opinions of men. The fear of the Lord and hatred for the enemy must be the driving forces of the modern day Esthers. They will have an anointing to gather people around the purposes of God. They will understand the times and the seasons of God like the sons of Issachar. They will facilitate gatherings of fasting and prayer to plead for life before the courts of heaven and earth.
Mighty God. The favor
that the modern day Esther will carry is not for selfish gain. They will understand that God's favor is to be used for their assignments in the earth. It's by God's favor that they will be able to bring forth granted petitions, even by ungodly civil authorities. This favor causes policies, rules, regulations, and laws to be changed and reversed for the advantage of the kingdom, as was seen in Esther 8, verse 5. Are you a modern day Esther? Where are you today on your own journey? Have you lost hope in seeing the promises of God fulfilled in your life? Maybe you're thinking, there have been so many terrible things that have happened in my life that God could never use me. Maybe you have said to yourself, I've made too many mistakes. I want you queens this afternoon, this evening, to perish the thought. You're a prime candidate for the service of our king.
Yes.
Just think about Rahab, a prostitute who was part of Jesus's lineage. Think of the woman at the well. The Bible declared her as an evangelist. The Bible is filled with so many flawed people who did great and mighty things for God. And guess what? Queens, you can too.
Yes.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now we saw Queen Esther rising from trauma to triumph.
Mighty God.
I'm sure.
Lucky master.
Some of us queens have gone through traumatic experiences.
Amen.
Bless the name of the Lord. But I want to tell you this afternoon, that's not how your story ends. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. The verb was taken in the verb in the verse can mean taken by force. The word taken indicates to be fetched or acquired like property. The king sent out a decree to gather the young girls. 1 minute they were at home with their families, and the next they were whisked away to the palace and placed in a harem. Their lives suddenly interrupted. Weren't our lives interrupted by COVID?
Ah.
1 minute we're going about our daily lives. Next we are thrown into fear, confusion, anxiety, loss of unprecedented proportions. It's easy to dismiss Esther as a lucky young girl or a woman who won the heart of the king, but she was a woman with a tragic background, having lost both parents. Praise the name of the Lord. Her given name was Adassah, and she lived in Israel when the nation was captured by King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon. Esther's family decided to stay in Persia, even though they could have returned to their homeland. Esther must have had hopes of being the mother of the Messiah, as many Jewish child would have imagined back then. She was a member of the Benjamite tribe, so the law of Moses would forbade her to intermarry with other cultures. So when the edict went out and the soldiers came to collect Esther, she must have known her life was going to be very different. Being in line to marry the king of opposing enemy nation was against everything she had been taught and raised to believe. I can't begin to personalize the fear and despair this young girl must have felt, being stripped from her family, knowing she would never, praise the name of God, knowing that she would be forced into behaviors or practices that went against her beliefs. These occurrences in Esther's life were unfair. She was indeed a victim, but her story offers hope. Praise the name of the Lord. Her story offers hope to all women who have faced traumatic, life-altering situations and trouble of any kind. God can work through our fears. He can work through our setbacks, praise the name of the Lord, to bring us to a comeback and to accomplish his purpose in us. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise God.
Have you ever felt as if your destiny has been taken? Maybe when the opposition seems unbeatable, you may wonder if God cares. You may feel alone in the world with its suffering and pain and injustice. I want to submit to you this evening, Queens, you are not alone, because our Father, the King, promised that he will never leave us nor forsake us.
Never.
Praise the name of the Lord. It doesn't matter how dark and dismal the situation may seem.
Thank you,
Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. We have somebody with us to share our heavy load.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. We may not always see his hand at work. We may not always understand what is happening, but we can trust his heart.
Hallelujah.
Because we know that the plans that he has for us are great plans. His words declaring Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not to harm you, thoughts to give you a bright future." Can I tell you, Queens, your future is bright. And I want you to declare that this afternoon, that my future in God is bright.
My future in God
is bright.
What a hope we have this afternoon.
Yes.
Irrespective of what is happening in us and around us, our future is bright.
Amen.
Oh, bless the name of
the Lord. Oh,
hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
There is a real enemy seeks to kill, to steal, and to destroy all our hope. What do you do when life becomes too tough? You may think, what can I do with all my baggage? Am I able to assist someone else? How could my life, reputation, comfort, and further rescue others? Great faith often emerges out of desperation and anguish, and people who perform brave deeds always battle fear and inadequacy, whether or not they want to admit. The hand of God is at work in the lives of his people. Just as he used the circumstances in Esther's life, he can use the decision and actions in your life to providentially work out his divine plans and purposes for you. This is your moment to be set free. The Lord will give you beauty for your ashes. The Lord will give you beauty for your ashes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ashes refers to the adversity in your life, and beauty refers to how the Lord can turn around these adversities for his glory. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. What an awesome God we serve.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Faithful God he is.
Praise God.
There's a song that I've grown to love. It says, "You're too faithful to fail me."
Hallelujah.
"You are too faithful to disappoint me." You've proven yourself in my life. And
praise
I have come to realize you're too faithful to fail me.
Praise God.
The other verse says, "You're too loving to leave me. You're too loving to leave me halfway." Hallelujah. What you start, you will finish. And I've come to realize that you're too loving to leave me.
Praise
what
God.
A God we serve. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. David says, "Whither can I go from your presence?
Even
if I go to the bottomless pit of hell, you are there. If I take the wings and fly to the uttermost parts of the earth, you are still there. Because
praise
he's
God.
The omnipresent God." Oh, praise the name of the Lord.
Praise
God
Jesus.
Is everywhere. And he sees everything that we go through. Praise and not God. Only that, but he is touched with the feelings of our infirmities.
Praise
the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus.
Praise God.
There was a time, Esther 4 verse 16 reveals a crossroad we must all face. Would Esther respond to the call of God to do something significant in history? This was a time when Esther had to make the decision to follow the purpose of God or to cower in fear. The easy way out would have been to abandon her purpose. But thank God that she chose to fulfill the purpose for which God had called her for. She came to the kingdom for such a time as this.
Glory to God.
The choice she would make would affect not only her life, but also the lives of many others. Praise the name of the Lord.
He's gone.
We were put on this earth to influence others. Praise the name of the Lord. When Paul and Silas were thrown into jail, it was not on account of them disobeying the instruction of the king, but they were placed in jail because of the jailer. There was a jailer and his family that were to be saved. You and I go through difficulties on a daily basis. These difficulties are not to harm us, but it is to mold us.
Yes.
Praise God. Into
Praise
what
God.
God would have wanted us to be, so that we would have a testimony that
yes.
would change somebody else's
yes.
life.
Yes.
Praise the name
yes.
of the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. Like Esther, your defining moment will represent your true self. You'll feel inspired to accomplish something greater than yourself. You may have defining moment that will lead to the breakthrough in your. You will have defining moments that will lead you to breakthroughs in your identity. And I heard Auntie Christine talking earlier about us knowing our identity, knowing who we are in Christ. If we don't know who we are, then when the challenges come, praise the name of the Lord, we will not be able to overcome. But when we know that we are children of the Most High God, when we know that the Lion of the tribe of Judah is on our side, then we are able to overcome all of our life's challenges. Praise the name of the Lord.
Bless God.
Take the time to look at those little things that have yes. occurred in your life. You'll find that one defining moment, that one signature moment, when you realize how magnificent and brilliant you really are, and that you are important, and that you don't matter in this world. One of my greatest feelings is, as an educator, when a child comes to me knowing almost nothing at all, and by the time that child comes to maybe the end of a term or two terms or at the end of the school year, you begin to see changes that
yes.
the child has learned something, or the child has moved from step A to step B.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes,
or when a child comes back to you after leaving your class
mm-hmm.
and comes back to you and says, Miss,
yes.
you impacted my life.
Yes.
A student that I taught so many years ago, the other day she just searched for me on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, Miss, you wouldn't know how much you impacted my life. I am who I am today because of you. It was a tremendous feeling.
Mm-hmm.
It was a feeling of self-worth to know
yes.
that I had accomplished or I had impacted somebody else's life.
Yes, yes.
And you in your sphere of influence daily. People are looking up to you.
Yes.
If you want to know that people are looking up to you, disappoint them. Do something that they didn't expect you to do. And you will hear them saying, I can't believe that so-and-so did that. You are an influencer, whether you believe it, yes or no, queens. So adjust your crown. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God.
Yes, God.
You will be able to identify the choices you make can have a great effect on the lives of many.
Yes.
God is awakening many women today to a purpose greater than themselves. He's calling us from a mundane experience.
Yes.
To a place of significance and fulfillment. Mm-hmm. Queens, adjust your crowns.
Amen.
You have been called from a place of obscurity, a place of indifference and inactivity. You are called to take a stand, to appear, to produce, to be intentional, to be revived from ruins. You have come to the kingdom for such a time as this. Bless the name of the Lord.
The
and
Lord,
I want us to
Lord.
Make some declarations this afternoon as I bring this Amen. To a close. Praise the name of the Lord. I want you to say, I declare that this is the year of favor, the favor of the Lord.
This is the year of the favor of the Lord.
This is the time for the favor of the Lord to be manifested in my life.
This is the time for the favor of the Lord to be manifested in my
life.
I am growing in wisdom,
and favor is being multiplied to me. And I receive preferential treatment, goodwill, and advantages towards success in every area of my life. I have favor with everyone that is assigned to my destiny.
I have favor with everyone.
The favor of the Lord surrounds me as a shield.
Amen.
I bless you this afternoon, Queen, as you recognize that you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this. And remember that there is a generation that is waiting on us to arise, the modern day Esthers, to arise and to fulfill the purpose for which we were called. Heaven bless you richly.
Thank you so much. Bless the Lord.
Heaven bless you. Let us just take some